This is the series of current economic sessions. We are on the first chapter, money and banking, most important chapter, and we will discuss rest of the chapters in the coming sessions. The sessions are happening daily at 11 a.m. PPT of this session will be uploaded in the Telegram group. The name of the Telegram group is @IEAS Economy. Apart from that, we are also having the classes at the 4 p.m. for GS2, GS3 and the mains current affairs. In today's session, we will discuss GS2 strategy, how to master GS2 strategy, the previous year question pattern. The classes is available at the same Zoom link. The Zoom link which you are using right now, the same Zoom link is applicable for the 4 p.m. class also, right? In the previous classes, we discussed all these concepts in detail, right? And today we will discuss Bessel norms, we will discuss NPA related terms, and in the next class we will discuss all these banking institutions, we will discuss all the e-banking related developments, etc. Okay, so the first term in the Bessel norms is capital to risk weighted ratio. So basically, before understanding this term, first let us see what is some fundamentals basically, right? So if we see a bank, what are the source of funding for the banks? Banks ke paas paisa kahan se aata hai? So the bank can get the money from shareholder in the form of capital, or it can get the funding from the investors in the form of loan, right? So ya to capital ho sakti hai, loan ho sakti hai. Capital can be in the form of equity instrument, and loan is in the form of debt instruments or bond instruments or debentures. So these are the two primary source of funding for the bank, right? Ye primary source of funding hai. Apart from that, the depositors, they deposit their money in the saving account, in the current account, right? As a part of the normal business. So that is a business. As a part of business, the bank is also getting the funds from the depositors, from the customers, right? Now, in the future, it is quite possible that the money which have been received from the depositor, when this money is further given as the loan, there is some default by the loan receiver. There is some default by the borrower, which we called as the NPA, non-performing asset. When there is NPA, there is loan default, it will be difficult for the bank to repay the money of depositors. Depositors ka paisa dena mushkil ho jayega, right? So repayment of this money will be difficult. And if that, in that case, the trust of the people on the bank will be reduced. Jo logo ka trust hai bank ke upar, wo khatam ho jayega, which is a very dangerous situation. Because why this is a dangerous situation? This is a dangerous situation because banking institutions are the core of financial system. They are the backbone of financial system. If banking institutions fail, the trust of the people on the economy will be disturbed. These banking institutions are the intermediaries which are channelizing the fund from the saving agencies, saving households, to the businessmen, to the government, and to the other people. So to avoid that situation, the bank has to keep some capital as the buffer, right? Ye jo capital hai, this capital and this loan, Now this will be used. This will be used whenever there is some loss to the bank. Jab bhi bank ko loss hoga because of NPA, this capital and loan will be utilized. So we have to have some minimum capital and loan always. Hamare paas kuch na kuch minimum capital ya loan hona chahiye, so that if there is a default by the NPA holders, if there is a loss to the bank, this capital and loan can be used. That is why this minimum capital to risk weighted ratio has been kept. ठीक है, ये रेशियो मिनिमम मेंटेन करने के लिए बोला गया है. सो दिस इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इन विच दिस CRAR इज मेंटेन्ड. नाउ आउट ऑफ दिस कैपिटल एंड लोन, दिस कैपिटल इज मोर रिस्की फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ इन्वेस्टर. इन्वेस्टर के लिए ज्यादा रिस्की है. व्हाई दिस इज मोर रिस्की? बिकॉज द बैंक विल नॉट पे एनीथिंग टू द शेयर होल्डर, to the investor, if there is a loss to the banker. अगर बैंक को लॉस होता है तो शेयर होल्डर को कुछ नहीं मिलेगा. बट इन केस ऑफ लोन, द पर्सन हु हैज गिवन द लोन टू द बैंक विल बी द लोन गिवर विल बी गेटिंग सम मिनिमम इंटरेस्ट. ठीक है, उसको मिनिमम इंटरेस्ट कुछ ना कुछ मिलेगा. सो दे आर लेस रिस्की, दे आर लेस रिस्की, राइट? And now please understand very carefully. I want to tell you that there are some different kind of bond which we call as additional tier 1 bonds, right? So first of all, what is tier 1, tier 2? So this capital, this capital which is more risky and given by the shareholders, this is called tier 1 capital. इसको टीयर वन बोलते हैं. और जो लोन दिया जाता है इसको बोलते हैं टीयर टू. सो टीयर वन इज अवेलेबल मोर फॉर लॉस एब्जॉर्प्शन. दिस टीयर वन कैपिटल इज हैविंग मोर लोन एब्जॉर्बिंग, मोर लॉस एब्जॉर्बिंग कैपेसिटी एज कंपेयर टू टीयर टू, राइट? बट देयर आर सम बॉन्ड्स ऑन विच द बैंक इज सेइंग दैट वी विल गिव यू हाई रिटर्न, we will give you high rate of interest, right? But we will be giving you this interest only when there are, like, you are agreeing to some conditions. Aap kuch conditions ko agree karte ho. The conditions are that we will not pay you any interest in case there is a loss to the bank, or in case the bank becomes non-viable. Agar bank non-viable ban jata hai, in that case we can even write down your value. That means we will not return back your money, just like in case of shareholder ki tarah hum aapko paisa wapas nahi karenge. So technically you are giving the loan, this is a bond, but this bond is of very very high risk. That is why this has been included in the tier 1. In the tier 1 we are including all the high risk capitals. So these kind of bond which are having some special features, they are also part of the tier 1. Wo bhi tier 1 ka part hai, although they are loan, but they belong to the tier 1. Theek hai? So is it clear to everyone? Jitna maine abhi tak bataya aapko sabko clear hai. Agar kisi ko clear nahi hai to please ask right now. If it is not clear to you, I want to clear your doubts here only. चलिए, तो इसको हम आगे डिस्कस करते रहेंगे. और अभी मैंने आपको बैकग्राउंड दी कि किस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में CRAR की जरूरत पड़ती है. ठीक है, नाउ दिस CRAR इज अ रेशियो. हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट दिस रेशियो? बेसिकली हाउ डू वी सी दैट हाउ मच इज द रेशियो और हाउ मच बफर कैपिटल वी हैव, हमारे पास में कितना बफर कैपिटल है, कितना हमारा एक्स्ट्रा कैपिटल है. फॉर दैट वी सम अप द टीयर 1 कैपिटल and the tier 2 capital, and we divide by the risk weighted assets. Theek hai, what is the meaning of risk weighted asset? I will tell you, right? So in case of bank, asset means basically the loan which they have given to the borrower and the investments which they have made into the various market instrument. So if they have some surplus money, they can also invest in the market. Agar unke paas mein koi surplus paisa hai, तो वो ओपन मार्केट में जाकर के उसको इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हैं. दे आर ऑलवेज फ्री टू डू दैट. वो हमेशा उस काम करने के लिए फ्री है. सो दिस लोन विच हैव बीन गिवन बाय द बैंक्स एज वेल एज दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट बोथ इज पॉसिबल फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ बैंक्स. ठीक है. ओके. टीयर वन कैपिटल. टीयर वन आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इट इज प्राइमरली इक्विटी कैपिटल, मोर रिस्की. एंड टीयर टू इट इज फ्रॉम प्राइमरली लोन अमाउंट विच इज लेस रिस्की. ठीक है. सो टीयर वन कैपिटल इज द कोर मेजर ऑफ बैंक्स फाइनेंशियल स्ट्रेंथ फ्रॉम ए रेगुलेटर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. राइट. इट इज कंपोज ऑफ कोर कैपिटल. कोर कैपिटल मीन्स द कैपिटल विच हैज बीन इन्वेस्टेड बाई द कोर शेयर होल्डर्स. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ शेयर कैपिटल दैट इज द इक्विटी शेयर कैपिटल एंड डिस्क्लोज्ड रिजर्व्स. व्हाट इज डिस्क्लोज्ड रिजर्व? सो बेसिकली इट इज द एक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ पास्ट प्रॉफिट्स. एक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ पास्ट प्रॉफिट्स. सो दीज प्रॉफिट्स ऑल्सो बिलोंग टू द इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर ओनली. देयर दैट इज व्हाई वी आर इंक्लूडिंग हियर ओनली. इट इज ऑफ हाइएस्ट क्वालिटी. Quality means that they are available fully to recover the losses. So in case there are high NPA with the bank, so this tier 1 capital will be reduced. That means the shareholder will not be able to get back their money. Shareholder ko unke paisa wapas nahi milega. Unka paisa milega bhi to kam milega. They will get less money back. Right. So this is about the tier 1 capital. This is about the tier 1 capital. It also includes additional tier 1 bonds. As I told you, there are some special category bond, right? Which are bond. Technically, they should be part of the tier 2. Tier 2 ke andar hum log debts ko include karte hain, right? But because of their special features, they are high risky. They are high risky and their quality is high. Their loss absorption capacity is high. That is why we have included them in the tier 1 capital. And we are discussing this thing because in case of Yes Bank crisis, this tier 1 bond, additional tier 1 bond were in news. Ye news mein the, isliye hum isko discuss kar rahe hain. Theek hai? In case of tier 2 capital, debt absorption capacity is less than the tier 1 capital. Now about the risk weighted asset kaise calculate hoti hai? So these are the assets. Already told you, the loan given to the customer or the investment made in the market. Ya to loan diya hua hai ya investment kiya hai. Risk weighted. So the different investment may have different risk. Different loan may have different risk. So if we talk about loan, if the loan is given to the government agency, then it is having low risk. If the loan is given to Mr. Mallya, it is having high risk. Right? Similarly, investment. If the investment is made in government security, there is low risk. If the investment is made in equity shares, then there is high risk, right? So this the risk can vary. Jo risk hota hai wo alag alag ho sakta hai. Accordingly, we are categorizing all the assets, that is the loan and investment, into the various risk category. So suppose these are the assets. This is the asset A, class A, right? So this asset A is having high risk and this is having very high risk. Sorry, this is having low risk basically, right? And this is having very low risk, right? So if we convert the value of these assets into the risk weighted, you can see this high risky asset, we are taking more weightage for this item. This low risk item, we are taking low weightage, and very low risk item, we are taking very low weightage, right? So according to risk, the weightage is given and the calculation is done. Calculation ki jati hai, theek hai? Now, in case of India, how much is the capital to risk weighted asset ratio? Theek hai, ye ratio kitna rakha jata hai and what is the breakup? So this CRAR is also called as capital adequacy ratio. Isko hum kya bolte hain? Capital adequacy ratio bhi bolte hain. Theek hai? Right? To check whether our capital is adequate or not, we call this capital adequacy ratio. Right? Now please see this statement very, very carefully, right? Understand this very, very carefully. So I am giving you 30 seconds. First, please read this carefully and then we will discuss this. Okay? This I have taken from the RBI website. Yes, I have taken RBI website. This is completely authentic, updated. Okay? So please take 30 seconds and review. Then we will discuss about it. बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Okay, so here you can see minimum common equity tier 1 ratio. Okay, sir, when does an asset become NPA? Preet, I will discuss about NPA in the next, next topic is NPA only after this CRA is over. Sir, tier 1 jyada risky kyun hota hai? My friend, tier 1 is high risky because in this case, if the bank faces the losses, first of all, we recovered the losses from the tier 1 capital. So the person who has given the tier 1 capital to the bank, that person will be facing the losses. Okay? Suppose I invest my money in the bank as the shareholder, the bank will adjust my capital. So my capital will be reduced. So the capital of the shareholder is reduced. So from the point of view of investor, from the point of view of shareholder, this is more risky, right? But from the point of view of bank, this is of high quality because this can be utilized for loss adjustment. ठीक है? तो ऐसा मान के चलो कि ये आपके parent ने आपको pocket money दी है, तो आपके parent के लिए ये खर्चा हो गया. और आपके लिए ये हाई क्वालिटी मनी है क्योंकि अगर आप तो खर्च भी कर दोगे तो पेरेंट को वापस नहीं देना. अगर आप अपने फ्रेंड से लोन लेते हो तो आपके फ्रेंड के लिए ज्यादा रिस्क नहीं है क्योंकि आपको फ्रेंड को वापस देना ही पड़ेगा, राइट? आप अपने फादर को वापस दो मत दो, लेकिन पेरेंट को तो वापस देना ही पड़ेगा. ठीक है? प्रीत इज आस्किंग सर, व्हाई डज ए शेयर होल्डर इन्वेस्ट इफ ही और शी डज नॉट गेट एनीथिंग एट टाइम ऑफ लॉस इन केस ऑफ बैंक? सो द आंसर इज बिकॉज इफ देयर इज प्रॉफिट देन शेयर होल्डर गेट द मोर, राइट? तो प्रॉफिट में भी शेयरहोल्डर जो है वो हिस्सा उनका होता है, राइट? सो इफ बैंक इज अर्निंग द प्रॉफिट ऑफ 30%, शेयरहोल्डर विल आल्सो गेट द प्रॉफिट ऑफ 30% एज कंपेयर टू लोन होल्डर. लोन होल्डर इज गिवन ए प्रोमिस्ड अमाउंट. सो फॉर एग्जांपल द बैंक प्रोमिसेस 5% इंटरेस्ट. सो लोन होल्डर विल बी गेटिंग 5% वेदर देयर इज अ लॉस और देयर इज अ प्रॉफिट. किसी भी केस में 5% ही मिलेगा, उससे कम या ज्यादा नहीं मिलेगा. देयर इज नो रिस्क भी ज्यादा नहीं है और रिटर्न भी ज्यादा नहीं है. बट इन केस ऑफ शेयर होल्डर रिस्क भी ज्यादा है और रिटर्न भी ज्यादा है. ठीक है? तो दोनों ही चीजें हैं. ओके, अनदर क्वेश्चन इज पोलोमी सर, आर द लोन्स गिवन बाय द बैंक्स इंश्योर्ड? लोन गिवन बाय द बैंक्स इंश्योर्ड? या सम ऑफ द पोर्शन कैन बी इंश्योर्ड, बट डेफिनेटली अगर इंश्योरेंस हुआ होता तो एनपीए वाली प्रॉब्लम ही नहीं होती. So it is very, very difficult to insure all the loans, right? No, the insurance facility is not available. It might be available for only few loans. Sir, if tier 1 risky hai, toh weightage kam hona chahiye. Okay. So my friend, weightage kam nahi hoga tier 1 ka. Achha, tier 1 risky hai, toh weightage kam hona chahiye. My friend, we are not talking about the weightage of tier 1 or tier 2. Theek hai? Risky hai kiske hisab se? Investor ke hisab se, hai na? बैंक के हिसाब से तो हाई क्वालिटी है, सो फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ बैंक दिस मनी शुड बी कैप्ट हाई, ठीक है, इन्वेस्टर के लिए रिस्की है, बैंक के लिए ये अच्छी क्वालिटी का है, इसलिए ज्यादा रेशियो उसका होना चाहिए। सर डज ए लोन गिवर गेट्स बैक फुल अमाउंट इन केस ऑफ लॉस टू? इट डिपेंड्स, सपोज इन केस ऑफ यस बैंक अगर लॉस बहुत ज्यादा हो जाता, ठीक है, तो लोन होल्डर को भी पैसा नहीं मिलता, ठीक है, सो इट डिपेंड्स, इट इज नॉट ए रूल, सो बट देर इज ए ऑर्डर ऑफ प्रिफरेंस, ऑर्डर ऑफ प्रिफरेंस है, इसका मतलब इफ देर इज ए लॉस द फर्स्ट लॉस विल बी टू द शेयर होल्डर, इफ द शेयर होल्डर कैपिटल इज बिकम जीरो after that the loan amount will be adjusted, that means even the loan holder will have to may have to face the loss in case the shareholder capital become zero, theek hai, isliye shareholder capital yani ki tier 1 ko hum high rakhte hain jisse ki agar zyada loss bhi hota hai even if there is high loss still the tier 1 capital is not short in short, theek hai, tier 1 capital kam na pade. chaliye so now let us come back to this regulatory capital. So the first item is minimum common equity tier 1 ratio, ठीक है, tier 1 ratio की हम बात करते हैं. So tier 1 ratio is 5.5%. Then there is capital conservation buffer, right? Capital conservation buffer is actually extra capital. The name itself suggests it is for conservation. That means only for emergency situations. So when economy is doing good, जब इकोनॉमी बहुत अच्छा कर रही है, everything is good, the health of the banks is good, bank are making the profit, at that time this capital conservation buffer is maintained, right? And this capital conservation buffer can be used when there are losses. जब loss ज्यादा होते हैं उस समय use किया जा सकता है, ठीक है. Minimum common equity tier 1 कितना हो गया? This plus this equal to 8%. Apart from that, there is additional tier 1 capital, which includes additional tier 1 bond. So this is 1.5%. Minimum tier 1 capital is 5.5 plus 1.5, that is 7%. This 2.5 is the buffer, which is not mandatory, but recommendatory. Ye recommend kiya jata hai, mandatory nahi hai. So banks are always advised that they should keep this conservation buffer, but it is not mandatory. Theek hai? Then there is tier 2 capital, 2%. So minimum total capital is 9% and minimum total capital ratio plus conservation buffer is 11.5%. So if we see, agar hum baat kare ki kitna rakha jata hai capital adequacy ratio, it is 9%, and if we include CCBR also, then it is 11.5%. Now you can see capital adequacy ratio is the ratio of bank's capital to its risk, right? So we are dividing this bank's capital tier 1, tier 2 by the risk weighted asset. It is the measure of amount of bank's core capital expressed as a percentage of its risk weighted asset. It is decided by the central bank. Please keep in mind who decides CAR. It is the RBI for Indian banks, right? So RBI decide karta hai, bank regulator. RBI is the bank regulator also. To prevent commercial bank from taking excessive leverage and becoming insolvent in the process, right? As per the Basel III norms, so Basel III norms have been prescribed by the Bank of International Settlement. Under this bank, there was a Basel committee. We will discuss about it in the upcoming slide, right? So Basel III norms stipulated a capital to risk weighted asset of 8%. 8% recommend kiye the. However, as per the RBI norm, we have kept it at 9%. So suggest kiye gaye the 8%, but we are becoming more precautionary. India is following more precautionary norms, so we have taken 1% extra capital for the banks. Now coming to the additional tier one bonds. Additional tier one bond kya hote hain? ठीक है. So this term has been used in the case of सर कोई बैंक लोन देने के बाद दिवालिया प्रूफ हो जाए तो लोन कौन वसूल करेगा? अगर दिवालिया हो जाएगा तो कैसे वसूल होगा? कोई कैसे वसूल नहीं होगा. इफ द पर्सन बिकम्स बैंकरप्ट देन द मनी कैन नॉट बी रिकवर्ड, देयर इज नो वे, है ना. तो जैसे महाभारत में बताते हैं ना, आई वॉज वॉचिंग महाभारत यस्टरडे. सो करण सेड that with the death the enmity also goes, mrityu ke sath hi hamari dushmani bhi chali jayegi. theek hai, to usi tarah se diwaliyapan ke sath hi loan bhi khatam ho jayega. theek hai. to agar koi diwaliya ho gaya aap kaise paisa vasoologe usse, hai na. chaliye, to sir crar, ccb, pcr aur lcr mein kya difference hai? aapne to bahut sare sawal puch liye, सारे सवालों का जवाब मिलेगा आपको, धीरे धीरे मिलेगा. हम सब कुछ डिस्कस करेंगे, ठीक है. एवरीथिंग विल बी डिस्कस्ड स्लोली स्लोली. चलिए, ओके. एडिशनल टियर वन बॉन्ड. सो दीज बॉन्ड्स वर यूज्ड इन केस ऑफ यस बैंक. ये यस बैंक वाले केस में हमने इसको न्यूज में देखा दैट इन केस ऑफ द यस बैंक बिकॉज यस बैंक केम इन टू ट्रबल देयर फॉर दीज एडिशनल टियर वन बॉन्ड वर रिटन डाउन. राइट, ये रिट डाउन हो, राइट डाउन हो गया. वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिटन डाउन? दैट मीन्स the investor will not get back their money. ठीक है, उनको पैसा वापस नहीं मिलेगा. And from the point of view of bank, bank's obligation becomes less or zero. So this is the meaning of write down. So from the point of view of bank, now bank's obligation has become less or zero, and from the point of view of investor will not get back their money. Right, so this is the meaning of write down. And why this is? Because the amount is very very big, thousands of crore ka amount hai bhai. Logon ne paisa invest kiya yes bank ne, aur yes bank ne bola ki aapka paisa wapas nahi milega. Theek hai, aisa kaise hua? Very, there is a like high curiosity. I know you are having curiosity, sir. ऐसा कैसे हुआ? So this is possible because there are some terms and conditions when these bonds are issued. कुछ terms and conditions हैं. So let us see the important features and the terms and condition. First of all, these are unsecured. Unsecured means the banks which is receiving the money as the loan do not pledge anything. है ना? So when you go to the bank, the bank ask you please keep something as pledge, kuch na kuch aap girvi rakhiye, right, tabhi aapko loan milega. Lekin in this case jab bank khud loan lene gaya logo se, when bank itself took the loan, it did not give anything as the pledge, that means it is unsecured. Perpetual means there is no expiry date. So normally these bonds have a fixed maturity period, for example 5 year, right? So investor will invest today, after 5 year the money will come back. But in case of perpetual, there is no expiry date. Then you will say, sir, what does that mean? Iska matlab kya hua ki investor ne paisa diya aur wapas nahi milega? My friend, the investor will get the interest income for lifetime, right? Usko interest milta rahega, right? Usko interest milta rahega lifetime ke liye, right? So it is not the investor will be in loss. उसको loss नहीं होगा, जिंदगी भर उसको loan मिलता रहेगा. It is just like you have a property, you have given that property on the rent, and lifetime you are getting the rent, right? So you are taking the full advantage of the property. Apart from that, they get the high rate of interest, right? So why anyone will invest into the additional tier one bond? Because the person gets the high rate of interest and there is no maturity date. I have already told you perpetual hai, koi maturity date nahi hai. Issuing bank has the option to call back. That means although there is no maturity date, but still the issuing bank, in this case yes bank, if it wants to return back the money, it can return back money at any time. ठीक है, तो कभी भी ये बोल सकता है कि अपना पैसा वापस ले जाओ और मेरे बॉन्ड वापस दे जाओ. सो देयर इज अ ऑप्शन टू कॉल बैक राइट आफ्टर स्पेसिफाइड पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो डेफिनेटली देयर विल बी सम टाइम, मे बी लाइक 2 years. आफ्टर 2 years एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम दे कैन बी ऑप्शन टू कॉल बैक. इट इज अट्रैक्टिव बिकॉज ऑफ हायर यील्ड. तो जो हमने बताया कि हायर रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट मिलेगा, इसकी वजह से ये अट्रैक्टिव बन जाता है. देयर इज ऑप्शन टू राइट डाउन और ऑफ. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज द पॉइंट बिकॉज ऑफ विच these additional tier 1 bond were basically written down. That when there is point of non-viability with the bank, that means the bank is in a crisis. For example, Yes Bank came into crisis. For some time there was a moratorium that depositor cannot take back their money, right? So there was huge losses which Yes Bank was incurring. So this type of crisis can be classified as point of non-viability. That means there is a question on the survival of the bank itself. कि bank जिंदा बचेगा या नहीं बचेगा ये ही नहीं पता हमें, ठीक है? So this is the point of non-viability. In such case, the bank has an option to write down. That means, like, it means that it will end its legal obligation to return back the money. Right? Now, risk kya hai for the investor? In this case, the issuing bank can also skip the coupon payment. Even the interest payment can be skipped in case of any risk. Agar koi bank ko crisis hai, to us case mein apne coupon payment bhi wo khatam kar sakte hai. Theek hai? So, in case of Yes Bank, these you can see the top holders of the Yes Bank's 81 bond, they are also called as 81 additional tier 1 bond or debenture. Nippon Mutual Fund, India Bulls, Franklin, Barclays, you can see 2482 crore. So this amount they have lost. Apart from that, there are at many other agencies, SBI, L&T, in sab logo ne apna paisa lose kiya because of Yes Bank. Theek hai? तो यस बैंक की वजह से इन सबका लॉस हुआ. दिस इज फर्स्ट टाइम इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन बैंकिंग सेक्टर दैट बैंक्स टीवन बॉन्ड्स आर ब्रिंगिंग डाउन आर बीइंग रिटन डाउन एट द पॉइंट ऑफ नॉन लायबिलिटी. दैट इज द इन्वेस्टर हैव टू टेक अ हिट ऑन बोथ प्रिंसिपल एंड बैलेंस पेमेंट इंटरेस्ट. यानी कि अगर हम बात करते हैं राइट डाउन की, सो बोथ प्रिंसिपल एंड इंटरेस्ट आर रिटन डाउन. दोनों के दोनों ही written down होते हैं, ठीक है? Both a principal and interest are written down. So this is very very important. Was there is in the news में बहुत ज़्यादा रहा था. That is why I have discussed here. चलिए. Now if you have any question, please ask me in the chat box. And rest of the people, please give the answer of this question. ठीक है? So what is your answer? Please give in the chat box. If you have any query so far, please ask in the chat box.
Okay, so I can see
all of you have given the right answer. Okay, great. Chaliye. Next question. So are you getting the clarity? जो भी हमने डिस्कशन किया आपको क्लियर हो रहा है? आर यू बेनिफिटिंग फ्रॉम द सेशन? आपको बेनिफिट हो रहा है सेशन से? चलिए, वेरी गुड, वंडरफुल. सो टुडे एट 4 PM वी आर मीटिंग फॉर डिस्कसिंग द जीएसट पेपर टू स्ट्रेटजी, हाउ टू सॉल्व पेपर टू क्वेश्चंस, हाउ टू मैक्सिमाइज द मार्क्स, which sources we should follow, what is the pattern of previous year, कौन कौन से एरियाज यहाँ पे हमें ज्यादा ध्यान रखने की जरूरत है, किस टाइप के क्वेश्चन आ रहे हैं, 2019 पेपर एनालिसिस, ऑल ऑफ दैट वी विल डू, राइट. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आई एम ऑल्सो स्टार्टिंग वन रिविजनरी सीरीज वेयर आई विल बी गिविंग यू सम होमवर्क. मैं आपको कुछ होमवर्क दूंगा और आप लोग नेक्स्ट सेशन में आने से पहले उस होमवर्क को करके आएंगे और मैं आपसे सवाल पूछूंगा. So are you interested in the homework? And I want to start with the government schemes. So government scheme is one area which is very important for the examination. Every year at least five questions come in the examination. And most of the time we are not able to cover because most of those things are factual and it becomes very, very difficult to revise those things. So I will be giving you compilation of government scheme in the Telegram channel. मैं आपको टेलीग्राम चैनल पे कंपाइलेशन दे दूंगा. यू कैन डाउनलोड कंपाइलेशन फ्रॉम द टेलीग्राम चैनल इमीडिएटली आफ्टर दिस क्लास, ठीक है. एंड आफ्टर दैट यू विल रिवाइज. ओके, लेट मी शो यू दैट डॉक्यूमेंट. मैं आपको दिखा देता हूं, ठीक है. Can you see this file? So schemes of agriculture sector, schemes of MSME industry artisans, schemes of water energy infrastructure, health sector, employment, right, education, sports, और सारी की सारी important news में रही हैं. This is the compilation of last one year का compilation है ये, ठीक है ना. So this is a compilation of last 1 year government schemes. There are around 198 topics hain, and I am promising you will get at least 5 questions from this area. Aapko kam se kam 5 questions milenge, theek hai. So I will upload this file on the Telegram group, and from this file your homework, main aapko homework bhi de deta hu, theek hai. To 4 pm jo hamari class hogi, us class mein हम लोग एक होमवर्क में आपसे आई विल आस्क यू क्वेश्चंस, ठीक है. सो योर होमवर्क विल बी फॉर द फर्स्ट चैप्टर. जो फर्स्ट चैप्टर है दैट इज द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर. हाउ मेनी पेजेस? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 अराउंड 4 पेजेस हैं. आप ये पेजेस कंप्लीट करके आइए एंड देन आफ्टर दैट नेक्स्ट चैप्टर आई विल गिव यू फॉर टुमारो एंड सो ऑन. सो डेली बेसिस पर हम 1 or 2 चैप्टर वी विल डू एंड your government scheme compilation will be done. आपका government scheme complete हो जाएगा. So this is one big area which you will be able to cover. So are you interested? How many of you are coming with the revision of this handout? Are you interested, everyone? Do you want to start me to start this initiative? I will ask some MCQ. आपसे कुछ MCQ पूछूंगा और आपसे मैं कुछ questions पूछूंगा. So you should recall and you should be able to revise, and that is how you will get benefit from this session. ठीक है? So how many of you are interested? Say yes in the chat box. Great. Good. चलिए start करेंगे. Someone please repeat the homework. Okay, homework मैं आपको बता देता हूँ. homework is the first chapter, that is the farmer agriculture schemes. The first chapter ki scheme hai, aapko padh ke aani hai. There are around 4 pages. Revise those 4 pages, read them carefully, and in the class we will discuss those 4 schemes. Hum unko discuss karenge. Theek hai? Chaliye. If you have any other suggestion how we can make these sessions useful, you can give me the time. आप मुझे सजेशन दे सकते हो, ठीक है, मुझे चैनल पे. सर when will you start the academic classes? My friend, I am having shortage of time. I am already committed to these classes at Right to Buy ES. So I have rejected the classes in the an academy as of now. मेरे पास अभी टाइम नहीं है. I am already committed to my existing student. So first my responsibility, my obligation is towards my existing student. इसलिए मैंने एन एकेडमी का ऑफर अभी रिजेक्ट कर दिया है. आई एम नॉट फ्री टू टेक द क्लासेस एट द एन एकेडमी, ठीक है, बट यू कैन कम हियर, आई विल डिस्कस एवरीथिंग वन हियर, ठीक है. सुराजित इज सेइंग सर गिव वन स्टैटिक चैप्टर. ओके, वी कैन स्टार्ट दैट ऑल्सो, बट अभी फॉर द टाइमिंग लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द गवर्नमेंट स्कीम. अभी हम यहीं से स्टार्ट करते हैं, ठीक है. लेट अस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर ओनली एंड नेक्स्ट क्लास हम लोग स्टैटिक के बारे में सोचेंगे, ठीक है. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, देयर इज वन मोर क्वेश्चन, प्लीज give the answer to that question. So the answer, what is the answer to this question? Question number 2, let me see aap logon ne kya answer diya hai. Chaliye question number 3. Are you enjoying the session, my friends? मजा आ रहा है? MCQ solve कर रहे हैं हम लोग, concept discuss कर रहे हैं, है ना? और अब तो government scheme भी start करने वाले हैं हम लोग. Mains भी पढ़ रहे हैं, prelims भी पढ़ रहे हैं, current affairs भी पढ़ रहे हैं, सब पढ़ रहे हैं. So at present, most of the students they are facing the problem of discipline, right? They are facing the problem of discipline. वो discipline की problem face कर रहे हैं, है ना? The answer to the question number 2 is option A. I will discuss the answer after some time. First, I will discuss the concepts. तो question number 3 का answer दीजिए फटाफट से chat box में. Please give the answer of question number 3 in the chat box. I can't see any answer from anyone. Please give the answer. Hitesh is saying option C. Okay, D. Okay, D. Good. Shivakam is saying B. चलिए, गुड गुड. आप लोगों का आंसर ठीक नहीं है, लेकिन फिर भी इट इज गुड दैट यू आर ट्राइंग. गुड आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन डी. ठीक है, आंसर इसका ऑप्शन डी है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 का आंसर ए है. वी विल डिस्कस द आंसर. ओके, सो बेसिकली आई हैव डिस्कस द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ CAR, कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो. दीज कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी नॉर्म्स आर पार्ट ऑफ द बेसल नॉर्म्स, राइट? Are part of the Basel norms. So first let us see what is the Basel norm. So Basel norms are the guidelines. These are the guideline which have been given by the Basel Committee on Banking Supervision. This Basel Committee on Banking Supervision, this has given the guidelines under various agreement. Such agreements are called, the combination of these agreement is called Basel Accord, right? The purpose of these accord is to ensure that financial institutions have enough capital on account to meet obligations and to absorb unexpected losses. The purpose is to ensure that there is enough capital, right? And if we see, there are 3 category of Basel norms: Basel 1, Basel 2, and Basel 3. Basel I came in 1988. In India, we adopted in 1999, and it was required to maintain 8% capital adequacy ratio. Basel II came in 2004, 8% ratio. Three type of risk, that is operational risk, market risk, and capital risk. ठीक है, operational risk, market risk, and capital risk. So what is operational risk? Operational risk is basically the risk of NPA, non-performing asset, the risk of turning the loan into bad account. ठीक है, market risk. So this is basically the risk of investment value becoming zero. So if bank has some surplus money, bank invest into the market, right? And there is always a risk that the amount can become zero, right? Amount can be reduced. There can be loss in the investment. So that is called market risk. And third is capital risk. Capital risk means when there is huge losses, there are huge losses because of NPA or because of investment, there is a risk that even the capital might be reduced. So capital kam ho jayegi uske wajah se. So that is called capital risk. So these three type of risks are covered in the Basel II. These three risks are also part of the Basel III also. Ye Basel III ka part bhi hai. Basel III mein, it was introduced in 2010 after 2008 crisis of financial crisis of the world, right? And it has four parameters: capital adequacy ratio, leverage, funding, and liquidity coverage ratio. We will discuss liquidity coverage ratio also in the upcoming slide. Right now, India is following the Basel III norms. If we talk about the agency under which these Basel norms are being adopted, so Bank of International Settlement, right? This is having the headquarter in the Basel City in the Switzerland. Okay. So these are the facts about this organization. There are three pillars of Basel III, right? Three pillars kya hain? The first pillar is minimum capital requirement, basically, which is nothing but the CAR, capital adequacy ratio, which is having three risk: credit risk or operational risk, NPA wala jo hota hai, theek hai, market risk, investment wala, or credit risk is basically capital risk, right? Market risk and operational risk. Then there is supervisory review. That means the central bank will be reviewing whether all the norms of Basel are being implemented. So there will be regular assessment. Regular assessment hoga. Theek hai? There will be regular assessment. And third, market discipline and disclosure. That means the banks will be giving suitable disclosures in the financial statement. So this will bring transparency. This will bring transparency and this will bring discipline, market discipline. ठीक है, तो minimum capital requirement, supervisory review, and market discipline and disclosure, these are the three pillars of the Basel III. So you can see the answer to your question. Okay, before that, let us discuss the news. ये news में ये था, this is the news. So basically, this Basel committee, this committee started a review process under which it started regulatory consistency assessment program. So what is this program? Under this program, the Basel committee is checking or assessing whether the Basel norms are being complied or not, right? So in 2019, this exercise was conducted, and therefore this is the reason why this RCAP was in news. So ye current affair news hai. If we talk about Basel committee, it is having 45 members, and the members comprise of central bank and the bank supervisor from the 28 jurisdiction. ठीक है? Now, if we see the answer, RCAP, answer is A. In this case, answer is A. This is right information about the Bank of International Settlement. So this is extra information for you. This BIS is owned by 60 central banks. Okay, so this is basically the central bank of the central banks, and it represents countries around the world. which together account for 95% of the world GDP. So this is the extra information for you. Ye aapke liye extra information hai. Head office is not in Bern, it's in Basel. Theek hai. Here I have already told you minimum capital requirement, supervisory review and market discipline. All three are the pillars of the Basel III. So answer is option D. Answer is option D. Okay, you are saying there are 62 banks. Okay, in that case, answer will be D. Have you checked from the website of BIS? Aapne BIS ki website check kiya hai? So don't worry about 92%. This ratio keeps changing. Iska chinta mat karo aap. Members ki basically dekho. Just see the members. If you are sure that number of members are 62, okay, sir, in your PDF it is mentioned. Okay, yes, you are right. On the BIS website, it is 62. So answer will be D. Thank you. Yeah, you are right. So answer will be D in this question. The answer will be D. This is 62. So answer is D. Now please read this question carefully. Give the answer in the chat box. So I can see most of you are giving the answer C C C C है ना. तो अपने पड़ोसियों का आंसर देख के आप लोग आंसर दे रहे हो, क्वेश्चन को ढंग से नहीं पढ़ रहे हो आप लोग. आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए, वन ओनली, राइट. काउंटर साइक्लिकल बफर इज एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द सीसीबी. आई विल डिस्कस दिस. आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए. चलिए, सो लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट इज कैपिटल कंजर्वेशन बफर. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन दिस आरबीआई regulation that there is capital conservation buffer, right, which is basically part of the tier 1. So from the tier 1 also only this buffer will be kept, right. So this is a buffer. Buffer basically means something in extra, hai na, jo hum emergency ke liye use karte hain, right. So this is an extra build up of capital which is kept during the normal time, jab hamara country sab kuch acha kar raha hai, when there is good economic growth, profits are good, everything is good, right, which can be drawn down as losses when there is a stressed period. So whenever there will be losses, it can be used. It is based on a simple rule designed to avoid breaches of minimum capital requirement. So that means minimum capital requirement is 9%, right. So we try to keep this 2.5% extra so that whenever there are high losses, right, the situation is very bad, even then if we have to write off our capital because of loss, so this 2.5% can be utilized at that time and still we are able to maintain 9% capital, and the bank is not dependent on the government to increase the capital. Theek hai, agar ye 2.5% maintain nahi karenge, in that case what can happen? In that case, it is possible that this 9% will come down and the government might have to basically capitalize this bank. To avoid that situation, the capital conservation buffer has been kept. And this is fixed at the rate of 2.5%, and this is built up in the phased manner. Ye phased manner mein built up hota hai. So, for example, 0.625% in 4 years, right. So 2.5% of RWA in the form of common equity. So this is the CCB or capital conservation buffer. Then next is counter cyclical capital buffer, right. So this is extension of the CCB capital conservation buffer extension, and this can be made, this can be formulated, or this is required whenever there is high credit growth, right. So the bank are giving huge amount of loan, very very high loan. So to protect the bank from the eventuality of high losses in the future, this buffer is kept, right. So this is called cyclic, like this is used in case of cyclical systematic risk, right. And this is an extension of the another buffer, that is the capital conservation buffer. So this is not the replacement, right. This is an addition to, extension of CCB. This is additional, right. This is additional. CCB is mandatory. This is mandatory for the Indian banks, and this is not mandatory. This is not mandatory. ये जरूरी नहीं है, ठीक है? But this mechanism is recommendatory. मतलब suggest किया गया है, लेकिन mandatory नहीं है. CCB is mandatory. Range of this can be 0%. 0% why? Because this is not mandatory. This is recommendatory, and maximum this can be 2.5%. That is equal to CCB, right? So this is CCCB, counter cyclical capital buffer. So please take 30 seconds and read this slide carefully so that your concept is very very clear. चलिए, सो दिस हैज बीन इन न्यूज बिकॉज आरबीआई हैज डेफर्ड द इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ काउंटर साइक्लिकल कैपिटल बफर बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड, बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड. ठीक है, तो ये 2015 में हम लोग ने मैकेनिज्म स्टार्ट की थी, राइट? इन 2015 वी स्टार्टेड दिस मैकेनिज्म ऑफ काउंटर साइक्लिकल कैपिटल बफर, बट वी हैव स्टॉप्ड, राइट? सो आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए. आंसर इन दिस केस इज ऑप्शन ए. सो फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज राइट, स्टेटमेंट टू इज रॉन्ग बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट द रिप्लेसमेंट, दिस इज द एक्सटेंशन और इन एडिशन टू द कैपिटल कंजर्वेशन बफर. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज लिक्विडिटी कवरेज रेशियो. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द बेसल नॉर्म्स ओनली, बेसल थ्री नॉर्म्स. सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लिक्विडिटी? लिक्विडिटी मीन्स एनीथिंग विच इज इक्वल टू कैश और कैश इक्विवेलेंट. ठीक है, या तो कैश हो या कैश इक्विवेलेंट हो. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कैश इक्विवेलेंट? दैट मीन्स समथिंग विच कैन बी कन्वर्टेड वेरी इजिली इन टू कैश. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड कैश इक्विवेलेंट. उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? कैश इक्विवेलेंट. सो इट कैन बी कैश और कैश इक्विवेलेंट. कैश इक्विवेलेंट फॉर एग्जाम्पल वेरी शॉर्ट टर्म इन्वेस्टमेंट, इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर वन डे टू डे, राइट? दैट कैन बी कैश इक्विवेलेंट, राइट? कवरेज, दैट मीन्स देर शुड बी सम लिक्विडिटी टू कवर एटलीस्ट 30 डेज ऑफ कैश आउटफ्लो विद द बैंक, राइट? सो द पर्पस ऑफ लिक्विडिटी कवरेज रेशियो इज दैट बैंक्स आर सपोज टू हैव सम रेगुलर कैश आउटफ्लो, राइट? Now banks should ensure that they have the cash and cash equivalent, that is, they have the liquidity equal to 30 days of their cash outflow requirement in the future. तो जो upcoming 30 days में उनके cash outflow होने वाला है, कम से कम उसके बराबर they should have the liquidity with themselves, right? And this is a kind of stress test. ये हमें टेस्ट करता है कि हमारे पास में वेदर आर वी एबल टू एंटिसिपेट मार्केट वाइड शॉक एंड डू वी हैव द लाइक डू वी हैव द सफिशिएंट मनी टू राइड आउट एनी शॉर्ट टर्म लिक्विडिटी डिसरप्शन. सो इट इज क्वाइट पॉसिबल कि अगर हमने ये 30 डेज का लिक्विडिटी नहीं रखा, वी कैन फेस ए प्रॉब्लम व्हेन डिपॉजिटर कम इनटू द बैंक टू टेक आउट द मनी, द बैंक विल नॉट बी मे नॉट बी एबल टू पे बैक. So to avoid that situation in the short term, we maintain this liquidity coverage ratio. How do we calculate? So this is the formula. High quality liquid asset matlab cash and cash equivalent. This includes cash, very short term investment, etc. Divided by total net cash flow amount in the next 30 days. Right, so LCR is calculated by dividing a bank's high liquid asset by a total net cash flow over the 30-day stress period. The high quality assets include only those with a high potential to be converted easily and quickly into the cash. Right, so any question till now? Abhi tak koi question aapka? So we have to complete today's session. I thought that I will complete NP also, but NP requires another one hour at least. I will discuss each one of these things in detail tomorrow at 11 a.m. I will discuss sab kuch discuss karunga NPA ke bare mein. Theek hai, we will discuss everything about NPA. There are some small terms which we'll discuss tomorrow, and we will also discuss these guidelines of RBI banking institutions. Theek hai, so not all the chapters will take so much time. Money and banking is something which is very very conceptual and